You're watching Boxing Entertainment TV.
Doesn't really use
uppercuts of his. Judah's face is he's becoming very uncomfortable with the situation and the way that the fight is going. And as you said, Jim, it's interesting that Cotto's left jab is being more effective than Zab's. Gonna keep doing that over and over and over.
Miguel Cotto's
he's got to fire something back. He's not shooting. He's a lot of. There it is.
Cotto dominate the round by hoping for the perfect punch.
One of those left hands from Judah has hurt Cotto in the mouth, and that's where the blood is coming from. And now Cotto seems to want to do damage right away. As long as one might have expected to recover from a low blow amid the blood flow. Hard left hand inside by Judah.
And that he's been working on and training is the last thing that he needs to throw to.
Mission of imploding.
There it is again. Judah. There it is again. Cuts off straight left.
Judah is getting a lot of opportunities to land his counter left hand.
It's a bad lip. I think it's a bad gash in his lip. I think his lower left lip has a bad gash inside.
Meanwhile, Judah is bleeding outside his right eye.
In mind.
And Cotto's starting to do damage.
But Judah usually does his best work in the first half.
Judah around the ring with his wider stroke. Both fighters are looking from time to time at Mercanti. Cotto's starting to make his point.
The most effective punch on
Cotto's assault. Left hook to the 32 out of 75 to only 9 out of 39 for Judah. This is one of the problems for Zab Judah in some of his big fights. Back into his regular stance.
Cotto's doing exactly what he should do.
You're looking at blood on both fighters. You're looking at physical warfare. 20, 25 left. He's landing only 13% of them. That would normally be the case against a conventional fighter. But he hurts Judah with the right hand.
Looks like he's stunned and he didn't have
to work on the body.
He's stunned.
Zab Judah starting to blink with the right eyes. Still quite apparent.
It's a big factor in this fight, whatever he throws.
All the way down to a limbo squat. Blood starting to flow above Judah's right eye. Into the ropes. The will of Miguel Cotto resurfaces one more time.
Consistency.
Judah's best round since the first, but in the end, Harold let him.
Come on, fellas.
That's what he does.
Judah does have a history in the. I've seen Corey Spooks.
Judah spending most of this round trying to get away.
Systematically, Cotto is breaking him down.
Another left hook by Cotto. Hey at Judah and gets the blood to flow from Judah's right eye again. Left, left, right, left to the body.
And he thought he had a man that he could take out, take advantage of some openings if they develop.
9 and 10 on, he's been brutal and relentless, including his 11th round knockout of Urkal in his last appearance. A 6 for Zab Judah. And more strikingly, Judah only threw 32 punches. He needs to throw more. It's Cotto who keeps the look unsteady on his feet.
Yeah.
Much of the crowd standing as Cotto continues the vicious assault. Arthur McCanny watching closely. Judah goes to a knee.
I think that was a good call on Zab's part.
like waving a red flag in front of an angry bull. As if Miguel needed any further evidence of his dominance at this moment. Hard left hand by Judah. But in the 10th. And he's trying. Back into the southpaw stance. Back into the full swing in the 10th round. Two low blows early. And say, what would have happened if he didn't fire? The fight.
Jim, you must exactly what's reading my mind. It's just what I was thinking about. He's been so cool amid all of the pain that he's going through. He's never changed his expression.
Down up. After the knockdown and the ninth, Judah landed two big shots. He doesn't run anymore, or so it appears. And Arthur McKinney stops the fight.
To all the Filipino boxing aficionados, please leave your comment, like, and share this video, and don't forget to click the subscribe button. This has been your channel, Boxing Entertainment TV.